spiritual flowers blossom in this deluding world. Celestial arts were brought to earth.
Supreme Master Ching Hai, with the childlike heart, spontaneously creates anything into a work of art.
With the delicate and penetrative perception of a painter, she puts her heartfelt vision onto the canvas in fascinating colors.
With the magical prose and great talent of a poet, she transfers her sentiments and love into soul-stirring poems.
With the gentle romance of a musician, she expresses her passionate feelings through beautiful compositions.
With abundant love, the culinary artist shares her creative scrumptious vegetarian dishes with the public.
With the innovative creativity of a designer, she creates gorgeous fashions with celestial clothes, produces dazzling celestial jewelry.
Designs the longevity lamps to glorify the brilliance of our inner heaven.
With a natural flowing and ethereal inspiration, she painted stones and fans,
built waterways, the zigzag bridge, friendly courtyards, and our holy meditation hall, turning a wasteland into a beautiful realm.
Although the Supreme Master never received any artistic training, her creative works encompass almost all art forms.
Such inspiring creations can only come from the deepest inner spirit.
You have to have time for yourself, to think, to be yourself again, to be within yourself, to develop your inner quality, to remember your inner quality. Like an artist, very leisurely person, very loving, stress-free, then you can give.
Our magical power is to use our hands to transform something useless into a flower vase, or to cultivate vacant land into a fertile field, or to develop a dry barren land into an orchard filled with fruit trees. Such is our magical power, Supreme Master Ching Hai.
Shihu Center is a place that was created by Supreme Master Ching Hai's magical power, turning a piece of desert land to a beautiful spiritual palace's grounds. Full of warm and lovely scenery, it is supposed to be the biggest creation from Supreme Master Ching Hai.
Actually, I did not start in Taiwan, even in the first place, to have a spiritual village at all. I didn't have any village, to tell you the truth. When I first started, I don't even have a house. And when I first came, I just stay in a temple, like every other nuns or temple worker, clean the bathroom, clean the floor for the people to come in and worship the Buddha. And that's it. And then afterward, I don't know how I became famous. I forgot. Somebody dig me out. Yeah, somehow. God, yeah, he play some game. And then so after a few times, and I have some students. When I came down, I stay in their house. But moving, you know, sometimes stay in this house, sometimes stay in another house. And then later, so many people follow me. And I just follow. Wherever I stay, they stay. And then we rented the house, because at that time I have so many people. Cannot stay in one room, you know, disciples' house anymore. So we rented a small room. And then we work, you know, handwork or something together to pay the rent and sustain ourselves. That was in the beginning. And then later they sold the house, so we became homeless. We left home again.
Music.
later on, we can buy a piece of land. It was very cheap in the beginning. The piece of land that I bought for the people in Mali, it was very cheap, dirt cheap, because nobody went there. What the Taiwanese people say, Niao bu sheng tan, means the bird don't even lay their eggs there. It's such a desolated place, that's what I mean. You know, even birds don't come and lay their eggs there. That means a very bad place. No survival chance, because no water, very dry, and there's nothing around there. Soil is not fertile. It's a kind of very sticky soil which people use it to make bricks, you know. It's very special clay, very sticky. So you can't plant so much things there. And you have to really work hard to make the land loose. Then you can plant something, but it's not so much. So not too many people stay around there, and not many people buy land. And then we came and buy some. It was so cheap, and then we settled there. And because at that time, I have so many monks and nuns hang around me already. I need a place for them. They can't just hang around the river all the time. And also, during that time, we have a lot of other people, like so-called lay followers come to us. So yeah, we have the place, because it's convenient also, the place is cheap, and then we buy. And then they all come, and then it developed until, and then we bought more and more within the years, and then it became Mali. Open temple right now in front of you, the best and the most and one and only ashram in the whole world, which everyone bring their own temple.
Entering the Shihu Center, there are no grand temples or mansions, no resplendent decorations. All we see are rustic, serene and natural sceneries, people meditating under the soothing shades of green trees and bamboo. The sky is vast and limitless, as well as their hearts.
那个时候西湖还没有水，没有电。那师父交代我们先做一些厕所。但因为以前那个旧大殿本来是养猪养鸡的，哇，那个味道你是根本没有办法走进去的。那我们就用很简单的方法，把水泥涂在岩来的墙壁上面，那把鸡寮啦、猪舍，它的大便啊，都把它清得很干净。而且没有味道。那后来师父来的时候，哇，他就非常的高兴。然后我们就在旁边用竹子遮了一个帆布，那那个就是早期的旧大殿。
Very soon, more and more truth seekers started to join the group meditation in Shihu. Our original canvas hall became too small for the crowds, especially during rainy days.Master suggested that we simply replace the roof with metal sheets and still keep the hall open-air style like a pavilion. Draping canvas around the hall, we could keep the rain out. Even though our hall had nothing remotely resembling a grandiose or majestic temple, we all had a most wonderful time sitting inside, where we enjoyed simple life and spiritual freedom.Later, the hall was returned to its original natural state. The metal roof was removed, we planted many trees on the land, and now they have grown so tall that they shade the entire hall of nature. The sunny beams are sparkling from leaves, just like golden specks dropping on the ground. Breezes are flowing, tree shadows dance around, birds are singing, the air is full of flowers' fragrance.Meditating in this surrounding, one can easily achieve the Zen state of one with the universe. Till now, the meditation hall can be called a big hall, so called the Forest Meditation Hall.
here is the coolest place, very cool, yes, because we have a lot of trees here and no naked soil, so it doesn't reflect the sun that much. When the sunshine comes down, it filters through the leaves, and when the wind blows, also filters through the leaves, therefore a lot of fresh air. And also here there is a stream, so the water always runs around, and the vibration also make you feel cooler. At least the mind make you think it's cooler here, because there's water. It works in many ways, that's why I keep you here. I think it's prettier here, because all kind of variety of flowers and trees, yeah? And also different level, you can have flat and you can have a little bit higher level, you know? You can sit next to the river if you want to. You don't have to sit here underneath of your Bodhi tree, yeah? But if you like it, it's fine with me. Here, everywhere you can sit from the big hall to the three or four levels of the riverside.
The Supreme Master Ching Hai says, the real ashram originally exists in our heart. Everywhere we go, we are in an ashram, so we should just relax and accept whatever comes. In the beginning, there wasn't any particular plan. Later, she bought the Shihu Center because of the needs of sentient beings, as well as to cope with the changing situation. That was also the reason for the modifications to the main meditation hall.
Here is the back hill covered with lush trees and bamboo. Even now, we still seem to hear Master's words of wisdom and humor echoing throughout. Up there, we used to have a stage upon which Master gave her discourses. As more and more people came to listen, she felt the need to develop the surrounding areas for the disciples to sit and commune with the divine, or to simply enjoy the lectures. So the residents built a wooden stage at the highest point of the center.
我这里为什么需要一个房子呢？也不是为了师父住啦，我现在常常也住帐篷啊。那个房子是放东西啊，书啊，文件啊，材料啊，土地的东西啊，公文啊，不一定为了师父才盖那个房子。本来要弄一个台而已，为了大家坐在下面，师父再告一点讲，大家都看得到。这个台很小，这样子再盖那么四四方方，很小，好像两个火柴盒啦，合在一起啊，不然你不需要房子，住帐篷正好舒服啊。
As time moves on, even though the lecture stage has since gone, the memories of the days passed by are fondly etched in our minds. With Master sitting on the stage, kindly talking to us, and the disciples seated below, surrounded by the forest, attentively absorbing her wise words.
现在你们回去哈，要想一想，自己所得到的东西，然后把它应用在这个世界，让我们的世界多快乐，多美好。
The Treasure Pavilion isn't just a two-story gallery of Master's artworks. It was also a realization of Master's beautiful intent to protect the environment.
那时候会取名为宝物亭，是因为那个时候宝物亭刚新建好，为了迎接师父从日本回来，给他一个惊喜。我们就把所有创作品都放进去，也布置得很漂亮。当师父回来时，一踏进去看到后很高兴。在参观中，师父就说：“我们把这里命名为宝物亭。”
这是两个是新的画画吗？
记得在日本有一天啊，我们刚来那个房子的时候，就空中有那个月亮哈，然后四周没有云了、啊，就有一个圆圈圈这个样子，真正的是这样子，我们全体都看到，真正的有一个圆圈圈这个样子，然后他们就用录影带啊，录影带还有那个叫上去叫不到，我没办法，我就赶快了，乱画起来这样。
The Supreme Master never accepts any offerings. So, in the early years, she earned her living by knitting and producing other handicrafts. She then started to paint stones, pottery, and canvas to reach the masses. So the residents suggested to construct a place dedicated to displaying Master's artistic creations for all people to appreciate.
宝物亭的地是后来才买的，那来西湖的人越来越多，不方便，那邻居既然要让路，那我们就多买了那块地。那因为下雨的时候泥土会流失，那为了水土保持，师傅就建议说做一个挡土墙。
因为那个山坡很陡，就快两层的高度啊，两层到三层的高度，所以我们当初就设计一个比较稳定的挡土墙，做成框架式的一个小写 H 型的一个架构的挡土墙。那我们做到一半的时候，师傅说：“哎，这个整个很像一个房子嘛，那我们是不是多加一个楼板？那上面就可以多一个空间使用。那既然有挡土墙的功能，那只是多铺一个楼板，那我们就多一个空间可以使用。”
Upon the completion of the treasure pavilion, the outer appearance of the structure harmoniously blended into the green surroundings. Master's artworks displayed inside filled the pavilion with the radiance of love.
God created the world in 7 days. While we built a crystalline nectar river in just 3. Under the insightful guidance of Master, and with the concerted efforts of disciples, we worked non-stop for 3 whole days and nights and created with our own hands a river with waterfalls and rapids through the middle of our ashram.This small waterway meanders through the ashram, cheerfully carrying its refreshing, purifying spring water, blessing the atmosphere with its beauty and elegance.
献给你们的小孩子，
谢谢师父。
谢谢上帝佛菩萨让我们这么快三天就弄完了，谢谢你们，都是没有佛菩萨加持不会这么快。
不是的，我全部爱心精神都放在那边，因为好久我想了你们的小孩子，夏天的时候他们来这边啊，有那个瀑布那个水池啊，现在啊住这个永久使用啊，大家小孩子快乐，大孩子也快乐，佛菩萨也高兴，真善美。离开了，这个瀑布代表真善美
Without any construction blueprints, and without any other information, using only the equipment available, Master used an umbrella to lead the way. Where she pointed and traced on the ground was where the river was to be built, and indeed it was miraculously completed in 3 days.
建造甘露河要先铺水泥及摆设石头。师傅说，整个甘露河就是不要看到水泥，可以擦的就擦干净。不能擦的就撒一些石头，让人感觉就好像在天然的溪流，清爽舒服。
那时已经是半夜了，在很累的过程中又下着雨，那像我们搬运过来的时候有一些众生，那我们在晃的时候都被师父提醒说，哎，那边有蚯蚓啊，为什么你们没看到？所以我们就发现我们很累，那似乎也很累，可是我们就没有办法注意到那么小的细节，但是似乎都注意到了，似乎对生命的尊重让他随时随地都可以感受到一些小众生的存在，并且去保护他们，爱护他们。
Most of those resident disciples who participated in the formation of the Nectar Riverdidn't have any engineering experience. Nevertheless, our progress was so quick, and the outcome was so perfect. It could only be due to the grace and wisdom of our great teacher, Supreme Master Ching Hai.
他们弄那个石头在那个墙壁有没有？啊，然后我就问他说，弄到什么时候？他说，哎呀，很慢了，很慢了，刚一点点而已。说为什么那么慢？他说有两个人啊，创业而已。这两个创业的同修，从花莲请过来了。哎呀！我就看他们做没怎么样，我在那边就小洋洋的说，等一下我去看看，去看看。啊，结果超心，你哒哒哒哒哒哒哒哒哒哒，好快好快呀！今天什么人都会做，因为他们看着我会做，他们就会做。
After paving the stone walls to make them more beautiful.And to preserve the soil and stones. With the holding stability of the tree roots, everyone worked through the night, planting big trees. Under Master's loving guidance and endeavor, the surroundings of the Nectar River were full of life and love.
When we dig, we put the whole big piece of dirt and roots together, then we use a rope to tie the roots and dirt together.绑得非常的牢固，让土不会在运送的过程中掉出来，这样被保护周到的树，它的存活率很高。师父是为了保护那些树木，所以不管花多少钱多少人力，我们就是尽量要把树种好、种活、种漂亮。
那有时候师父故意排那个在那里，有时候故意丢一点点在旁边，懂吗？我能照顾哪里我就照顾那里，因为我铺这大石头就变小石头就变，我都看情况嘛，把那个不自然的地方盖起来，然后撒一点小石头，重重的石头就很自然，看起来很像一个河边一样，懂不懂？ 像那种地方的话，师傅很细心照顾我，保护这些地方为了你们呢、啊。如果我一个人的话，我就远游四海，哪里有好的河我就流，我干嘛在那边弄一条河那么麻烦、啊、台湾难得有这么漂亮的地方，有那么人照顾的地方，有爱心放进去的地方，干净的地方，所以我们这边即使不是自然教主了，我们自己照顾过也很漂亮，而且很干净，我们每个礼拜每两三天都洗。
Such a cool, serene place was the creation of just 3 days' magical work. A meandering river unites 3 levels of terraced land into a harmonious and romantic scene of shading trees, mountain springs, waterfalls, and cool breezes. Along the winding banks of the Nectar River, many mature and strong trees were thus planted, expressing different scenes in every corner.We could be walking along a little tree-covered path and then suddenly come to an open space. The landscape design is so natural-looking and completely unassuming. Not only do people adore this place, but birds like it too. They fly around, singing along with the flowing stream.
师傅做那个河流啊，我随便画这个样子，也是一种画哎，也是一种艺术啊，专造啊。那个是真的有立体画哈、啊，真正的画，这个是真像画哈、啊，不是抽象哈、啊。啊，太好了，啊，太漂亮哈、
啊。弄一个河流这么长哎，好长好长，三天而已，还是要铺道路，还铺石头，还种树，哇，这个是真的神通广大，哇，好漂亮，好漂亮。现在在这瀑布开始，真的很浪漫的，
啊！哎呦，给人家灵感哈！哎呀，这个河太好了哈
！This creek was originally dug for the children to play in, but to protect the river from damage and to preserve the pristine water quality, people refused to play in it. Master thought.If that was the people's wish, then it was all right with her. From then on, under the loving protection and consideration of everyone, the Nectar River has always been kept pure and clean, and we have continued to be blessed with such a pure spring bestowed by God.
Stone pavilions are scattered along the Nectar River. They add a lot of elegance to the garden and the waterfalls. The craftsmanship of the pavilions was meticulous. They had to first crush stone slabs into regularly shaped pieces and then embed them on the stone poles and the roof. Master herself also climbed up to help decorate the roofs.She carefully considered and designed every detail of the pavilions in order to achieve a most beautiful and eye-pleasing look.
Okay, 大家慢慢看那个石头瓶啊、哦，我去看那个红色最好看，这个就是我叫出来的，真的好漂亮啊！这个我很骄傲，站在旁边给人家展览，真的这么漂亮，从没看过哈。嗯，我最怕是这个，怕这个不好做了，因为本来这些装饰都很厚嘛，我不能弄太厚啊，所以我叫他们破啊，把它破脆一点，破到一半呢，好像一半才可以这样子铺啊。如果把它原始铺上去的话，太厚不好看，因为它那个比例比较小嘛，所以这个很难做，还做得到，很棒啊。
The most exquisite designs are the stone lanterns hanging from the ceilings of these dignified and peaceful pavilions. These rustic stone lanterns are great companions to the elegant, serene-looking pavilions. Together, they form an absolutely natural and harmonious whole.
哎呀，太漂亮了！没有这个灯的话，这个凉亭不怎么好看呢、啊。是啊，因为它比较单调嘛。哎，看我高兴哈！哇，真的看不腻哦。不晓得你们喜欢不喜欢，我真的好喜欢。我随便画在那个卫生纸上面、啊，随便画这样子，它就量那个比例啊。我还以为它比较大、比较高，结果我们先陪上去看看，刚好刚好，结果还是蛮好看的哈，像画圈一样啊，那自然，远看近看不一样啊。哎，那个简单而已，简单的灯啊，我画半分钟而已，两个，就是做比较慢了、啊，做是比较慢，而且这个也简单，不是很复杂的，你看就知道是不是？我们大概 一天半就弄好了，六个灯。包括设计的，设计是半分钟不要算了。我叫他过来在旁边坐一坐，然后这样这样，哎，好，好这样好了，哎，哇，真的很漂亮哈，大家看得很喜欢哈，哎，哇，太漂亮了，嗯。
Throughout the ages, the Himalayas have always been regarded as the residence of the gods. The great enlightened yogis would retreat to the caves of these holy mountains and live there in solitude. In Formosa, our Shihu Center also encompasses two beautiful and spiritual mountains. One is named Lotus Mountain because it looks like a seven-petal lotus from afar.The other mountain is Mount Supreme Sound, meaning enormous sound current. On these two mountains, one can find many caves amid the angelic beautiful scenery. The quiet and spiritual atmosphere gives them a feeling of heaven on earth, and makes an ideal location for self-cultivation. Hidden among the lush green trees on the mountainside, there are small cute caves.Half concealed by the trees, they are not conspicuous. They prevent soil erosion and provide shelter from wind and rain for the long-term residents. Again, like all her other superb insights, Master's idea served a practical purpose. She personally designed the shape and structural layout of the caves, and then provided the details to the residents so they could make their own homes. Master constantly checked.And made sure that everything went to plan, just as a professional architect would.
The caves that we made by hand ourselves, beautiful. We dig out the mountain, né? The mountain like this, because we want to protect the landscape. Né? The mountain were very difficult. The back mountain, there are two shapes. One is a little bit flat and a little bit sloppy like this.But the other one is so slanted like this, you know. But when we dig cave into the mountain, wow, you look down, they are so beautiful, it's out of this world. Really, Himalayan caves are not as beautiful. The way structure, you know, so beautiful, because we wanted to also protect the landscape and the environment, so we don't destroy the mountain shape, we keep it. So we just dig into the mountain and then build it inside.Very beautiful, very beautiful.
From a professional architect's point of view, we know that building structures on a mountain slope has to follow very strict regulations. For any amount of soil we excavate, we have to fill in the same amount of soil in order to minimize the damage to the topography. It's not easy to achieve structural balance when building on a hillside.However, the caves we built on Lotus Mountain involved very little excavation or filling. All we did was strengthen the existing caves so they wouldn't collapse.
我们每个山洞哦都有特殊的私密性，因为山路一直这样盘桓挫折，那一路走到这个山洞，那就到不了这个山洞，所以各自独立，互不侵犯。在一般的建筑规划里，除非很精密的测量，否则很难达到这样的效果。师傅很有智慧的处理陡峭的这个坡地啊，使山洞形成一座座很坚实的挡土墙。
Every cave is a home and a heaven. These caves spiral along the mountainside, one on top of another, like they are trying to reach the sky. After Master gave the residents instruction to build their own caves, even the female residents drove the big trucks, struggling up the hill. Together, they overcame the challenges provided by the steep mountain slopes. They formed teams to make their work more efficient and harmonious.
挖好的时候要整理的是大部分都是交代我们种野鸡，野鸡长得会比较快，野鸡啊抓土啊，这样啊它土石流啊比较不会容易流失啊。
这样一来，当台风或者是雨季来临时，就可以维持住整个山形和它原始的样貌。这一切都是师父为了守护地球的爱心和远见。
After the caves were completed, the residents had to use their individual talents to beautify the surroundings of their own dwellings. So each cave now has its own unique beauty. In 2003, concerned about the physical well-being of some of the elderly residents,Master instructed us to decorate with wooden planks in our caves. The wood materials would keep the interior warmer in the winter and cooler in the summer. Furthermore, it could dehumidify the caves. Master so considerately also detailed the method of how to put the wooden planks in.
师傅的指示里，他把细节讲得很清楚，连木工都没办法想象。很简单，就是一个木头能在山洞不上漆。几乎是所有的木工都会想说，没上去怎么可能啊？做了之后，整个山洞的气氛都变了，住的可以说像山温暖一样享受。而且师傅当初特别交代一件事情，要做圆弧形。山洞的木头用弧度的，摆设的是横的，一般外面做法都是摆直的，横的好像一个弓的形状。它那个木头纤维质经过弓的形状挤压过后，慢慢的把芬多丁一点一点的释放出来，那种感觉真是很好。圆弧形可以帮助整个木头的排列，有那个力量的感觉，真的是相当完美的创作。
住在山洞的感觉就是说，夏天的时候你进去的不会像外面哇那么热，冬很夏冷，冬天的时候哇那特别温暖，哇它那温度差不多20度啊，十几度，很舒服啊。
The winding path leads to a secluded place behind the flowers and trees. In the back mountain of our Shihu Center, there is a cave where Master used to reside. Her personal cave is no different from those of the resident disciples. It's also small and delicate. Outside the cave, there is serene and beautiful scenery, while inside, there is nothing but simple rustic decor.The Supreme Master has two caves in Shihu, one for her office and one for her living quarters. She designed and supervised the construction of both caves, which were built after the resident disciples had finished building their own caves.
You thought I live in a big house there? No, I live in a cave, 2x2, 2 meters by 2 meters. That's all I need. And then we built all that for myself and for the monks. We built it all in 2 months. Very nice inside. Inside we put wood now. Before it was not wood. But I tell them just put wood so that it will absorb the dampness. No, now it's very dry, very nice. Oh, I never want to leave that cave. If I sit in there, I said, I don't want to go out. And it feels so big, bigger than any room I ever lived. Any palace I have ever been. It's just a cave, a small cave, 2 meters by 2 meters, like every other resident as well, huh? Nothing special. Each of them decorate their different, and I make mine different, you know. Not too different, but, you know, just the entrance or whatever. The way you put the faucet, you know. whether you put the stone around it or you put sand around it, you know, just make it a little different. We have water in front of the cave, you know, with a tablet, we cover it with stones so it look natural. Yeah, flower or whatever they do it, yeah, okay. Yeah, that's what I designed to build. The 2x2 by everybody, because nobody is taller than 2 meters by us anyway. So 2 meters is good enough for us. And I say, well, just correct size, you know? You open the door and then you jump onto where you meditate. If it's too big, then you start cleaning up, decorating, and then you don't have time to meditate. That's enough. Yeah, many of you don't even know the caves on the back mountain. We live in caves, we are cave people. We are capable, huh? We build it all together, the residents and I. Not like an outside professional, yeah? Man, woman, same. Big, small, the same. All carry beton and making, iron tied together and put cement all together. We do it, but we hire some machine to do it, you know? So we do it all together in 2 months. 200 caves. I don't count it, but more or less like that, including mine. Huh? So I'm just telling you, that's how we built it. Huh? We just happened to build it. So if we build it, we build it to last. Yeah? There's no other way, you know, because this is safety for them, you know, because that mountain sometimes is soft, you know. I see some of that mountain the erosion. So we have to build it strong in case the mountain fall down, the cave stand there, you know. So that's how it is. And 2x2. And we can't afford to build more than that. The mountain is small. If you build more than that, we don't have room anyway. Number one, number two, that's all we need. Huh? I said that's very economical, simple. No problem. That's why we build it just enough, yeah, 2x2.
Constantly and selflessly working to serve sentient beings, whenever she has spare time, the Supreme Master will do the thing that she loves most to do, beautify this material world. She is an expert in this field. For her, it only takes a spontaneous artistic idea and some very simple decorations. Even when living in a cave, she still displays her gifted aesthetic talents. By the placement of just one carpet, the ambience in the cave was elevated dramatically.
In people's minds, the phoenix is an auspicious symbol. Our ancestors believed that during peaceful and prosperous times, the phoenix would grace the world with its presence. But no one has ever seen this mythical bird in modern days. However, we have a building in our Shihu Center that is decorated with colorful tiles and looks just like a phoenix perching on top of Lotus Mountain to make the spiritual mountain more splendid.
在旁边南仲搭了一个比较简陋的铁皮屋在主幻，那师傅去看就觉得说，那已经有可以办公的地方，也有住的地方，如果把吃的地方弄干净弄漂亮的话，那是更好。所以师傅就跟我讲，如果把那个铁皮稍微扩大一下，就可以给南仲有一个吃饭的地方。那个铁皮刚好是一个长条形的，师父说这个长长的，如果我们把旁边有平的地方把它变成翅膀的样子，把它做成斜斜的，所以整个的过程当然是依照师父的意思。后来 师傅有跟我们解释说，他说你看这样子像不像一只凤凰。他还要求那个外墙要去市面上找一些很漂亮的瓷砖来给他显，那是希望是彩虹的颜色。所以你看到那道墙是全世界大概是唯一的，什么颜色都有，包含我们请来贴瓷砖的同修多说，他已经贴瓷砖贴了30年，从来没有这样贴过瓷砖的。
Even though Master was very busy during this time, she would still come to inspect our work daily and give us invaluable suggestions. So, the phoenix came to life from Master's personal design and intuitive supervision.
这个房子全部都是我盖的。像那个柱子有没有？我说弄圆的，因为已经都四方太多了。房子四四方方，屋顶上方方四四，然后柱子又四四方方，然后砖头又方方四四。哎呀，太硬了，懂不懂？他们这边都是工了，已经很硬了。啊呀，又这么硬了，怎么受得了呢？所以叫他们弄柱子圆圆的，而且那个这个桌那个圆的最简单了，你去买那个人家弄好那个水泥管子嘛，不然的话那个水管那个塑胶啊，把切开两半啊，结合起来就好了，中间已经有那个铁柱子了，啊，抱起来然后喷那个金亮亮的，哇，看起来像皇宫一样，很快啊，现在那个圆的比较好看。而且最简单的是吗？然后我们多放几块木板，上面圆圆给它装潢一下就 OK 了，看起来像皇宫一模一样。哎，而且又很快，这个没有超过一个小时就弄好了。哎呀，很简单啊。
In the oracle bone inscriptions, Chinese characters for phoenix are the same as for wind. They symbolize an omnipresent existence, rich in spiritual power.Phoenix also represents royalty, which itself represents the supreme and the highest. When we say the phoenix graces us with her presence, we mean to describe a noble person with very fine inner qualities and graceful manners. Master designed the building in the shape of a phoenix, with its profound meanings, not to mention the building itself was also delightfully pleasing to look at.
This place used to be a fish pond. Concerned for the suffering of the fish that got caught, the Supreme Master Ching Hai leased the fish pond from the landlord and built the zigzag bridge over the pond for people to take a rest and enjoy the placid scenery. After the insect-infested pond was beautified, while standing on the zigzag bridge, one can now see schools of fish swimming leisurely in the pond.Creating gentle ripples on the aquatic surface. Because no one fishes there anymore, they have started to multiply in number and are now more healthy looking.
我们在做这个九七桥的时候，我们的工作时间大概只有五天左右。那现场没有图啊，所以我就跟同修讨论，就那个桥应该是七折的，然后在七折的桥面上面，我们希望有两三个凉亭，然后有三个出口。那在水里怎么焊接呢？因为都是烂泥巴，你没有办法固定那个柱子。那后来我们就来了一个铁工的同修，他对那个柱子怎么在水里面固定，他特别的有心得。那我们就按照他的方式定位之后就很有进度了。那个时候我们有三组不同的焊接的同修，我们就从三个不同的出口点，然后慢慢的把这个桥组装起来。所以他在架设每一根柱子的时候，我们就在湖边讨论说，再往前3公尺，然后组装的同修就做好3公尺。那我们又跳到另外一个出口，跟组装的同修说，你们再往前6公尺，那第三个出口就再往前4公尺。它的流程就是在现场形成的，没有人知道，做的人也不知道那个桥最后会是怎么样。做钢骨的同修就控制那个定位，因为能定位是这个工程能有进度的一个最大的关键。整个工作出乎意料之外的顺利，很快的基本上那个弯曲度竟然从三个不同的点一起出发，最后连成一条九曲桥。
Supreme Master Qinghai always had wanted to have a place where children could play to their heart's content. She wanted everything in this children's playground, including the plants, to represent happiness, joy, and positive thinking. Master started to plan this paradise playground, which children had been dreaming about in the fall of 1995.
当初这个彩虹岩是一个慧根的稻田，杂草丛生，没有任何的一棵树。那师父为了照顾小朋友，让我们移植了非常多的树木，然后可以给小朋友在树荫下面可以玩。那为了不要被太阳直射啊，而且特别交代我们把玩具都要放在那个树荫底下，而且要把那个安全措施做得很好。那有一次啊，我们不小心就把秋千放在那个太阳底下，那师父看到了就说，那小朋友在太阳底下怎么玩呢？你们把玩具放在那个地方有什么用呢？所以师父会照顾到每个细节，不是说摆个玩具给你玩，他还顾虑到小朋友应该怎么玩，是不是能够安全，能不能够遮到太阳啊，可以不可以很自由自在的在那边玩。他希望我们能够把每个细节都照顾到。
Master told us we could paint with the walking paths in the garden with all kinds of colors, so it would look like a rainbow when people looked at it from the sky. Master also named this playground the Rainbow Garden.
他几乎就是为了大众想，为小朋友想，希望他们又安全又好玩，然后能够最接近上帝那种品质。他希望小朋友来到彩虹岩，能够让他们回忆起那种天堂的境界，到处充满鲜艳丰富的色彩，让他们可以随意的游玩跟嬉戏。
哎、欸。居然他们玩漂亮。
你会不会累了？要不要抱？
不要抱起来。
没关系。我们彩虹园那些动物啊，啊，那些动物是我画的。
有一些
啊，最多颜色就是我画的，哎、欸，因为他们画不够颜色。他们太保守，有一些保守，他们画一只猪，就真的像猪一样，
好像很像。
我说我们这边猪跟外面猪不一样啊，我们这边是天堂的猪啊，啊，是什么皇家的猪啊？应该给他穿什么王冕啊，还有龙袍啊，什么一大堆的，怎么那么黑黑漆漆这个样子？然后我自己又下手了，我说你应该这样画那样画，小孩才喜欢。哎，他们后来就知道了，就很多颜色了，这样比较好一点，有进步了。哇，神颜色啊，啊，上帝给我们好多颜色，都好神啊。猪就画像猪一样，然后牛就画像牛一样，黑漆漆一片这样，那何必呢？何必给他画呢？啊，出去买，或是出去外面看就好了啊。我说你应该要用想象力丰富啊，有那个颜色出来，有活泼，那个自己装造出来另外一只猪啊。是吗？那我们自己里面呢要出来啊，我们那种很快乐的、很活泼的、很多颜色的那种精神呢要出来啊，在我们画的时候，在我们做事的时候，都把那个生活、啊、把生命力啊、把那个快乐带到这个世界来啊，不是 copy 那个已经很黑暗这个世界啊，啊，是吗？嗯，我们把这边变小天堂也可以，我们不能改变整个世界，最少我们改变我们家，哎。我们整理干净，能玩弄我们家能活泼快乐出来，总里面快乐，然后外面也装潢快乐，那、啊、上彩虹园等等给小孩玩呢，哎，这样他们就不会吵你们了，看快乐，他们心就不会闷了，就不会想念天堂啊。他们太想念天堂的时候会吵你们父母，因为他们这边找不到任何东西给他们快乐啊，所以才吵父母啊，才皮啊，才讲不听话啊，因为他已经不在意了，无所谓了。听话也是这样子啊，也是一只牛黑黑的，比方说这样，那没有什么那个生活，没有什么动机可以活了。所以你们父母要给小孩概念啊，要活泼起来，要给他们很多那种类似天堂那种境界，他们就安心了。
In 2007, Master specifically instructed the fellow initiates to paint some sculptures that depicted the peaceful coexistence among animals.As well as stories about how they help humans, and then place those sculptures in the Rainbow Garden. This was to let the children learn about the loving acts of our co-inhabitants while they play and have fun.
师父当时只是我们能否收集英雄动物，像狗、猫、猪、鹦鹉等等的简短故事，把他们的照片和故事刻在不会毁坏的东西上面，放在彩虹园的不同地方。让小孩子们学习和爱动物，越多种类越好，而且可以持续增加。
One of the stories depicted was about a hound dog named Shayna, living in New York State, USA, who bravely saved her human companion's life, caught in a severe snowstorm. Shayna frantically dug up the snow and mud. Her courageous actions showed that she is a loving being with a compassionate and noble soul.Shayna really deserved to be called a hero. These stories of love and compassion were represented by colorful sculptures that made the Rainbow Garden even more vibrant.
Fellow initiates of the Supreme Master Qinghai International Association come from all over the world, Europe, America, Asia, Africa, and Oceania, and represent all ethnic groups. So each time there is an international retreat, many fellow initiates come from all over the world. Fellow initiates from different countries, different ethnicities, put down their worldly work and come here to meditate together.Listening to the Supreme Master's discourses and enjoying a worry-free and blissful gathering. There is an international garden where these fellow initiates from overseas can enjoy themselves and feel at home. addition to emphasizing functionality in terms of soil and water conservation, Supreme Master Ching Hai especially cared about beautifying the environment of the splendid and brightly colored garden.
因为呢，原来那边是就是常住的帐篷区，就是我们大家迁过去那边以后，整座帐篷区比较空了。那时候也时常举办国际餐了，然后师父希望说给国际同修有多一个休息的空间，所以说就只是曾经在他身边种过花草的常住们哈，就开始美化那一区。师父他对这样一个爱心，就是一方面是要把我们这块土地注重环保，让水土保持以后，借由美化的方式去保养这块土地，然后一方面也可以提供国际的同修有一个休息的空间。
We are making some garden, you know that, huh? And we need some rocks, huh? And you can roll them around. Especially those who have strong body and a lot of energy, and may roll some rocks for the females to do gardening. You're trying to make use of some of the places. See, like for example, the higher hill slope, you see? See that? They used to be the tent area for the children and women who has children. Mm. So now we convert it into a kind of garden, you know, with flowers and...soft grass and hard rocks and paved walkways, things like that. So in case if you ever come back again, you can have a stroll in the garden, you know, feeling that you're at home.
With her brush of love and wisdom, Supreme Master Ching Hai painted the Shihu Center into a beautiful paradise of truth, goodness, and beauty. Surrounded by lush greenery and pervading scenery, the amazing splendor of Shihu Center was a convergence of efforts, similar to putting the pieces of a puzzle together. In the beginning,Shihu Center was merely a piece of deserted farmland. As the number of fellow initiates grew quickly, more space was required for meditation. Gradually, the center expanded to the rear hill. Thus, the whole place took on the form of a soaring crane.
Shi Hu 他根本没有刻意要建设一个道场或是一个建筑物。那整个过程呢，并没有特别的规划。说我们现在在这里做一个椅棚啊，我们在这里要做一个厕所，是一个没有计划中的一个计划，它只是解决当下遇到的一个情况。那师父希望说大家来的时候能够很高兴很愉快，所以我们就把道场弄得很干净很美丽，然后尽可能的把环境弄得很清幽，让大家能够赏心悦目。
The spatial arrangement throughout the Shihu Center is truly astounding. Appreciating it from different points of view, it is truly full of innovation and very meticulous care and glory.
一般的设计，不管是建筑物或是其他的产品，它一定会先有一个构想，它会有一块的基地，然后我们再来规划，厨房放哪里，厕所放哪里，然后大厅放哪里。可是我们是刚好倒过来，我们是随着时间演变才决定，这个地方是大殿，这个地方是厕所，所以我们甚至连要用的土地在哪里我们都不知道。那今天有一点钱我们就买了一小块，明天有一点钱就在旁边再多买了一块，那随着时间的累积， 我们能使用的空间就越来越大。那师父对道场空间的设计啊，以我们现在打坐的立场来看，你会发现当初的决定是非常的正确，安排非常的简洁，那现在使用起来非常的方便，那简直是神乎其技。如果我们当初没有正确的决定，很多东西使用起来是不方便的，尤其在五六千人甚至一万人在使用的时候。
The Supreme Master has reminded us that as soon as we enter the main entrance of Shihu Center, we should only have happiness and joy. Before entering the gate, all of us should leave our vexations behind. Thus, Shihu Center is not only rich in the physical beauty of the landscape, but it is especially precious because of the intangible, blissful atmosphere which allows people to forget their worries and have peace of mind.As well as to feel loving warmth and grace as if returning to our old home in heaven.
When we had the Meoli, huh? Everybody happy, huh? Remember, huh? When you went there, you feel good, huh? Right? This is true also because the spiritual atmosphere built up with the years and you like it. When you go there, you feel like at home. Because it was the most beautiful place in Taiwan. Yeah, we made it so beautiful.
爱就是师父最大的设计法则，因为他就是想到我们，让大家怎么打坐方便，怎么打禅方便，怎么来这里搭帐篷方便，他只想到大众。所以师父的设计原则就是因为他爱大家。
有人问我说什么是加持力，那我觉得这就是一种无形的爱力，因为师父他是用爱心来建设这个西湖道场，道场里的每一寸土地还有每一份建设都有师父满满的爱力，所以在任何角落我们都可以感受到那一份爱跟喜悦。这里真的是师父留给世人一个最珍贵的礼物。